everyone. In this session, we are going to discuss various problems faced by students while writing answers to the questions in theory paper. These problems ultimately lead to less scores in exam despite having good knowledge or sufficient knowledge of the subject. We had received similar representation from a previous batch also regarding the same problem. So we thought of conducting this session for students so that the students score better by understanding the way the theory papers are set and what are the expectations of paper setter as well as the assessor also, and student can focus on the important core areas of the syllabus also. To discuss on these issues today, we have invited Dr. Anita Chalak madam, HOD biochemist. So let us get solutions to these problems through the discussion with ma'am. Welcome madam to the session.
Thank you for inviting me for this session, and I would love to answer your queries.
Okay, shall we start ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, first question, amongst the various representations what we have got, what are the various common problems that teachers have been representing you?
Yeah, during the process of assessment, we often hear from the assessors, and I personally have also noticed a few issues or few problems, like sometimes the students are unable to completely write the answer, maybe because of lengthy paper or maybe because they don't know its answer. So that is one of the thing. Another thing is a few specific questions are left unattempted by the students. Suppose question A or question B is left unattempted by most of the students. So maybe there is some issue with that question or that topic has not been covered. We also have noticed that the answers which are given to the questions are not very specific. The answers which students give are vague. Like something is asked and the answer is related to that question but not very specific to that question. So in such cases, students lose their marks. We also notice, particularly in the question where there are two or more components, some component which is very important, which we as an assessor, we expect the student should elaborate in detail. But in that case, student writes it in very short. While the other part of the same question, which is not that important, and we expect little knowledge, little bit of the answer, but student elaborates in detail. So that there is some mismatch what we expect and what students write. So that also we notice. And one more important thing which I would like to tell here is students often attempt extra questions, which doesn't make any sense, which actually waste their time. So like long questions, writing extra, instead of wasting time in extra questions, they can spare that time for the questions which are compulsory for them. So these are some of the concerns which as an assessor we have noticed.
Thank you ma'am. The next question which we have received from student is, amongst the complaints of verbal communications received from the students, which were the major concerns of the students regarding the theory question paper or the items which are there in the theory question paper?
Yeah, this we came to know either by formal feedback. Sometimes we ask our students, how was the paper? So the students come out with so many things. Or sometimes we just observe and listen to students when they come out of the examination cell, and we just observe what they are commenting. So these are a few things which we have heard from the student. Like they often say paper was very lengthy, time was less. Then might be some students or most of the students study most important topics very well, like if we say carbohydrate metabolism or molecular biology, these are the big topics and students are well prepared for that. But the comments which we have heard is like, it is such a big topic, such an important topic, but only 2 marks question was asked in the whole paper. So less weightage is given to such an important topic. Or the reverse, more weightage is given to a very small topic, hardly 1 or 2 lectures are there, and the long question has been asked. Moreover, a short note is also been asked with the same topic. So a lot of weightage is given to a less important topic. Sometimes students also feel that the question is out of syllabus, though for medical students nothing is out of syllabus, but we often hear such comments. Then some students who prepare themselves right from the first year for their clinical years, they prepare themselves in a better way, taking clinical scenarios or clinical cases right from the first year. So some students also feel that there is no question asked on clinically important topic when they are well prepared for that. While other students feel that there is less weightage given to the basic when they are prepared for the basic. So it is all, these are all the concerns of the students. Sometimes they also say that the question was very vague and very unstructured. Like sometimes we just say describe something, like describe oxidative phosphorylation. So what was expected from the teacher? So such comments we do get. And they also are confused how much to write for a particular question, how much to write for a particular component, some question. And sometimes they feel the paper was too easy, sometimes they feel it was too difficult. So lot, these are some of the things which we often get from the comments which we hear from the students.
So this is quite surprising. Though we are so old in our assessment system, still we have a little communication gap between the paper setters, assessors and the students. So why do you think, ma'am, these problems are arising in our assessment system?
Okay, the assessment system itself needs to be taken seriously. We often see in many medical colleges, one of the faculty members is given the responsibility to set the complete paper, which is a wrong practice. Now what happens when a person is asked to set a question paper? Definitely he or she will be focusing on the topics which he likes, which the favorite topics of him, he will be putting more questions on that, and he will be putting less questions on the topics which he dislikes. So that is one reason why such a thing happens. Then another thing is, often the question papers once set is never moderated. So proper moderation of the question paper is very necessary to keep a check on overlap. If multiple examiners are setting it, then there may be overlap. A same question can be asked as a SAQ as well as an LAQ. So that has to be taken care through a proper moderation process. Another thing which I would like to advise to all the assessors also, that whenever you set a paper, we need to have a ready model answers with us. So we come to know, though we are experts in our subject, but still we should be very clear that for how much marks this question should be asked, and for that we need to have a model answer in front of our eyes. So while once we prepare a question paper, we should have a model answer ready, which will definitely increase the objectivity of the assessment as well as the quality of it. Also, improper distribution of the marks is one of the things which is being done. So again, model answer if ready will help in this. And structuring of the questions, unstructured questions we often put. So structuring should also be done by the assessors, which will help students and know what to be written in that particular component.
So these problems have been throughout the years of assessment or education. So how do you think these problems are affecting the assessment system?
Right. So if such is the assessment, such are the question papers, and then we get the responses from the students. Now, I can say that the whole purpose of assessment is lost. The assessment neither remains valid nor reliable. There is a lot of subjectivity in it, and it is what we intend to measure is not measured. What we intend to know from what students have learned is not being achieved. So, the whole purpose of the assessment is lost. Now, this assessment is linked with the delivery of the curriculum as well as with the methodology which we use for the delivery of the contents of the curriculum. So all these three things are linked. So if the assessment is proper, it will also give us a clue of how the delivery of the curriculum has been done, whether it has been done properly or not, as well as the methodology are used appropriately or not. So this is how we can link these three components and make the whole process proper.
Okay, then what are the solutions for this kind of problem or inadequacy of a theory paper? Do we have any solution, or just we have to adjust with that?
Yes, there are solutions. We can definitely improve these. We can increase the transparency of assessment. When I am saying transparency, it doesn't mean that we need to involve the students while setting or assessing the question papers, but at least the student should know what is the weightage given to the particular topic, so that accordingly he will prepare himself for that particular topic, and he should be also aware how he is going to be assessed, for what and how he is going to be assessed. Then the second thing which is required is faculty training, which is well done overall India, so that is not a big concern for us. Then structuring the specific questions with verbs, this all we learn with training, how to frame a good question, so that has to be done to improvise this. So here in preclinical subjects, I can comment, for preclinical subjects, the weightage which has been given to the recall type of questions is 50%, while for comprehension it is 25%, where student needs to think little bit, comprehend little bit, and the application, the weightage is given 25% for application as well. So it is 50, 25, 25 for recall, comprehension and application. Topic wise weightage the student must know. And for that we can have a blueprint. We can prepare a blueprint before setting the question paper, which will tell us that what topic will be given, how much weightage, and also it will take care of content validation. That means all the topics will be covered appropriately. So that is how, this is how we can solve some of the issues.
Okay, if these solutions are to be implemented, I mean to say, do we need to change the complete the entire assessment system, or these changes are possible in the existing assessment system also?
We need not change the entire assessment system. This is quite possible. Rather, it is easy to implement in the existing assessment system. A few things we need to take care. One is we need to sensitize our faculty for blueprinting. What is blueprinting and what is its importance, what is its purpose, and how it is going to help the assessor as well as the students. So that can be done, sensitization of the faculty for blueprinting. Then we, as I said earlier, we also tell the students the weightage of the topics and the weightage of the difficulty level of the questions. That should be clear to the students also. So there should be some transparency in the process of assessment. And this is how we can make the assessment a healthy academic activity, which will definitely benefit the assessor as well as the students.
Okay, ma'am. To understand it in a better way, can you please give us one or two examples of questions, how it can be said and how it can be reframed?
Yes, I'll give one or two examples. Like, for example, often you might have seen questions like describe dehydration as a SAQ for 5 marks, or simply a word dehydration and write. Now, a book can be written on a dehydration, an essay can be written, a long question can be written, a short question can be written, and a BAQ can also be written on a dehydration. So, while setting such question, describe dehydration, as an assessor, what I am expecting from my students will be different from what other assessor expects. So, the expectations vary from assessor to assessor, but student doesn't know what to write in that, because the question is very vague, described. So suppose I am expecting only the clinical features and definition of it, but some other assessor is expecting the etiology of it. So in this, in such type of question, student gets confused what to write, right? And for 5 months, they cannot write the whole dehydration. So how we can improvise this question is, like, if in place of describe dehydration, we can write mention causes of dehydration and describe its correlation by antidiuretic hormone system in detail, and we can in the bracket give the distribution of marks like 2 plus 3. The first component of the question will carry 2 marks and the second component of the question will carry 3 marks, so the student gets a clue how much to write for 2 marks and 3 marks. So this is how we can write.
Being two major stakeholders of the assessment system, students and teachers, so if we are discussing about the blueprint as a different approach to be taken to make a valid assessment system, so what is there for student and what is there for teachers when we discuss a blueprint approach?
So blueprinting, or the blueprint for question paper, definitely helps the teachers as well as the students. For students, they get an idea of the overall assessment, how they are going to be assessed and for what they are going to be assessed. They come to know about the overall weightage of given to a particular topic. So that's how they it's useful for them, and accordingly they can prepare for their examinations. Structured questions help students to know what to write. So if question is specific, students know what to write in that. So the vagueness of the question is gone now, and student can write whatever is asked. So that helps the student in writing the answers. And this way students definitely get the opportunity to score more marks. The whole process of assessment becomes reliable. The scoring becomes reliable. If the questions are structured and model answers are ready, then the of course the scoring will be reliable. It won't be more subjective because we have something in front of our eyes based on some criteria based on which we have to score the student. So it becomes reliable. This is how the assessment system, we can make it valid, reliable and transparent, which ultimately improves the confidence in the, of the student and their satisfaction. For teachers, whatever efforts they take while setting the question paper or during overall teaching or delivery of the curriculum whole year, there is optimal utilization of the efforts taken by the faculty by using blueprint. If you use blueprint, the paper setting becomes easy when we have a blueprint in front of our eyes, which indicates that this topic is to be asked for these much marks. So now it becomes easy for me. Now I know that 5 marks question is to be asked only on this topic. So paper setting becomes easy for the teacher. Accordingly, if everything is with us, the blueprint, the model answers, we can give proper feedback to the students so that they can further improve their performance. Model answer keeps a uniformity in the assessment. Paper evaluation and the paper setup is synced. If we do this, there will be syncing between paper evaluation and the paper setup. And it brings objectivity in paper setting and paper evaluation. So overall, it is very much beneficial for the teachers also.
So, what are the steps you have undertaken to implement this approach in previous years or this year?
Yeah, in our institute, that's ATS Medical College in KM Hospital, we have already completed one project on blueprinting in year 2017. And this was done for the old curriculum, but in 2019 NMC has introduced a competency based medical education curriculum, so the new curriculum, and now we have taken up this project for the new curriculum for CBME, which will be beneficial for the faculty of medical colleges under MUHS. All the faculty will also be involved in this project. We will be needing their opinions and feedbacks. As well, the students of St. J's Medical College in KM will be involved in this project. So, we are ready with the blueprint of the previous curriculum, as well as we have initiated the project for the new curriculum.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. As a student and as a teacher, I have got both overviews of the blueprint approach in assessment. As a student, if I am not wrong, I will be getting weightage of a particular scope of examination. Right, but as a teacher, so how will I understand preparation of a blueprint, implementation of blueprint in paper setting, and all the intricacies of the blueprint approach in assessment system? So how I, as a teacher, I can understand this?
Yes, for students definitely we will be giving the weightage as per the given by the MUHS or NMC, weightage for each topic, weightage for type of question, difficulty level of the question that we will be giving to the students. For teachers, of course, teachers needs to be sensitized for blueprinting. Lot of us, we've been trained in medical education, most of us, and know what blueprinting is. But still, there is some inhibition in initiating it or implementing it. So definitely, we will be having more sessions for validated weightage of the course content for the scope of upcoming examinations. Then we will have utilization of the weightage for blueprinting theory paper can be done. We will also discuss about SOP for blueprinting, then demonstration of the blueprinting with Excel sheet template, structuring and framing of questions and proper verbs, and how to set the theory question paper using the blueprint. So all these issues will be taken further in the following series of these sessions.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for sensitizing all the teachers towards using this systematic approach of blueprinting in assessment, and helping students also to have a good idea and overview of the blueprint. And at the same time, the utilization of the model answers along with blueprint, how it can, you know, streamline and bring objectivity in the assessment. That we have understood, and I am hopeful that all these sessions in the upcoming videos will help us understand the approach in a better fashion, and And on behalf of all the students and teachers, I thank you, ma'am, for this overall interactive session. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Thank you so much for inviting me for this session, and I hope it will continue, which will help students as well as the faculty all over the India, and keep doing good work.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.